All right, so you want to listen to those 8 bars?
Yeah, sure.
Or how about 4? How about 4?
Those four. I mean, it's the same thing.
Yeah. Twice, pretty much. That's those 4.
Right. So initially my thoughts, how it's written here isn't how I hear it.
Yeah.
I hear more of like that kind of thing going on.
Yeah, kind of that skank strum.
Skank strum. So it's like... Right?
Yeah.
And that's giving it kind of a thickness, especially with the distortion on or wah grit. You know, and then I also... Well, before I move on, what do you think of that?
Well, I think that's right. Actually, let's listen to it soloed without the drums in it. Because I totally agree with you. You can hear that, the extra muted strings in there. What I think you're going to say about the next part, let me see if I'm right. It's not played with those open strings. Am I wrong? I think it's played a different place on the neck.
Oh, it might be. But my initial thought was, it's definitely... I hear that as a pick, not as a pull-off.
All right, so this pull-off... You can't see my screen. So the first pull-off is a pull-off, right?
Like,
I think it's played there, yeah. Now, wait, I'm going to make one quick call on this. We need to do this all the time to review our sheet music. Do you agree?
It's a much better way.
Yeah. But the other thing is, John's not a guitarist. And there's things like this he's not going to pick up or play it a certain way.
Yeah, no, I'm down.
So wait, yeah, that does. So play that... He's hitting the next two, right? Dun dun. The first. Do it one more time for me. Okay.
Because what I'm hearing is that you get this, and then there's the wah on this note, which makes the attack of it kind of diminish. But I don't hear it as a pull off. Maybe I'm wrong, but I really don't hear it as a pull off there.
Let's listen to it again.
It's too present. The note's too present.
Yeah.
Even with the wah. I'm gonna stick to it. I'm gonna stick to what I'm saying. I think.
Wait, what are you playing the last notes? What are you playing for the last notes? Okay.
I mean, it could be any number of things. It could be, but I don't think it's that.
No, I don't think it's that either.
It could be.
I think it actually is that one. I think it is splitting hairs a little bit on some of it, right? But
it's a job, though.
So, and then on the beginning of the solo, you just say with wah wah skank strum with wah wah pedal.
Yeah, it's definitely that. And skank strumming, for all you out there who might be watching and don't know, is just hitting the strings muted while you play a single note in there. That kind of thing, and it gives a very percussive... You know, and you can see it in, for example, the Stevie Ray Vaughan stuff too. You know, and so that's where I learned it from anyway, was that and some Red Hot Chili Peppers.
So So a bunch of good skank parts that you can learn if you want to learn that technique.
Yeah.
All right, let's listen to the next four. So did I listen to the wrong four?
Yeah, you listened to the wrong four. You went to the interlude.
Let me change all eight of those measures live in real time.
Sorry, getting ahead of myself.
Yeah, don't learn the rest of the song before I get to learn the rest of the song, okay? Show off. No, that's not an ooh. So those eight measures, let's break them down. Tell me more.
All right, so let's first look at the chord structure. We got an A minor. Puts us firmly out of our initial key of A minor, back into it, all right, so that D would be the non-diatonic chord there, because A minor C F suggests we're in the key of C or A minor. And then the D gives us that F sharp coming from an F, right, with an F natural in it, to the D with the F sharp in it. And then back to F G, which is a 4-5 in C, or the 6-7 back to A minor. And let's see, F, and back to that D with the F sharp. Yeah, okay, so if we think about the notes of the A minor chord, that's A, C, E, and we're on a C note here. Right?
Yeah.
So that's just the third chord. And then to C, right, which is our root of that. And then to the F, right, which is the fifth, so it's third root fifth essentially is what's happening.
Okay.
Third of the A minor, root of the C, fifth of the F. And then on this D chord, we're getting this A, G, E, D, so it's a little walk down. But really what it's implying here is a D7 chord.
Okay.
It's that C natural.
Yeah.
And then you can tell it's just a riff though in A minor. Like he's not thinking chord tones here, because that's just a walk down the pentatonic in A minor. Mm. And it just, the notes happen to work for a D chord.
Yeah. And then an F and a G in the next measure, right?
Yeah. And then it's over an F and a G in the next measure where it's, you know, like that's, again, that's just an A minor walk down, because that D isn't necessarily a great chord tone in F. It's the 13, which is kind of jazzy, but you know, if you were going for like really landing on a chord tone, you wouldn't necessarily hit a D over an F. And then a C and A over the G, like, yeah, you're not thinking of a G chord
You know?
You're thinking of a lick or a riff in A minor. And then it kind of repeats. It does that same thing where you get this. If I can play a little bit better. Right.
Yeah.
I think accenting that C, which is again coming from the third of the A minor to the root of the C to the fifth of the F, and then you're back to your over the D, and then that same F G. Yeah. So that'd be my breakdown of it. It's just a lot of basically one A minor lick, which is this, and then just a lot of C notes that happen to work well with these chords.
Yeah. So count triplets for me. So you go, the song is swung, by the way, as well. I don't know if you heard it.
That's how it goes. Okay.
Dun, da, triplet, boom, boom, triplet.
Right. So I'm notoriously bad at counting triplets because I never did that.
Okay.
I don't know. I suppose I just felt them. And I think that's kind of a weird way to do it, perhaps, but I just go like one and yeah, probably that one and triple it, one.
Wait,
triple
tell me how you'd feel them though. Like what would be the different, I know how you feel them, but tell me how you feel them.
Well, my way of doing it, which is not suited for everyone, is a more feeling based way. I'd be like, okay, here's my pulse. And I go, and that's I don't know, that's how I do. I don't count it so much.
What I've been doing in lessons is that sometimes, because I know kids at an early age can't count. They won't count. They're not good at it, right? But I always say if you can mimic the sound of it, you're gonna be able to play it. You know, you can teach your fingers by mimicking that da triple bad habit.
Right. But I do think there's a lot of utility in using triplet or I think I learned one e and. So one and two e and three and four e and one and two e and three and four e and one e and two, three and 1E and 2, 3 and 1E and 2E and 3 and 4E and 1E and 2E and 3 and 4E and 1E and 2, 3 and 1E and 2, 3 and, you know, like that works too.
Now, when you're doing the triplets, are you going down, up, down, up, down, up? Is that how you generally play it?
So when it's the triplets, so when it's, okay, first off, you have the eighth notes triplets
yep.
in the first measure. So there I'm going down, up, down, up, down, down. So down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, right?
Gotcha.
And then when it's the triplets in a row, like in the next measure, so it starts with the eighth note, but then it jumps into three triplet groups.
Yep.
So I go down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. There I'm alternating.
Gotcha, okay.
Alternating. That's just my preference because it's easy for me.
I think it makes sense though. It's very much like sticking. It wants to follow a pattern, right?
Right. And at this tempo, it might be kind of tricky to go on that second measure or even on measure 80 to 81 where it's all triplet groups. It might be tricky to go down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down. Mm. You can do it, but it's probably easier to go down, up, down, up, down, up.
Yeah, and I think the best thing you could do is set a metronome, right? And just practice your triplet.
Preferably good and slow. So I would start off without a metronome and just go very much like one and triplet. You know, and just try to get that feel, and then start a metronome right around the tempo that you were doing it at without one.
Okay.
Nice and slow, nice and easy, and just really kind of lock that in. And from there, slowly increase by, I don't know, I like to increase by like 3 or 4 BPM per run, cycle. Some people suggest doing only 1 BPM per cycle, which I thought was a little bit extreme. Some people like to go as much as 10 or more per cycle. Like they feel like once they've got it at, say, 70, they can jump right to 80. I feel like that can be a bit of a leap. I don't know. I like to feel really comfortable at whatever tempo I'm playing. And sometimes if I jump 10 BPM, I can start to feel a little pressured or tense.
Yep.
And I don't like that feeling.
No, and I think that's usually the guide to back it back down. You know, I think if I played a part for 5 days in a row, then I can probably do the 10 BPM jump. But if it's my first day, it should be like a 4 or 5 BPM.
Right. All right.
All right. And then let's break down the pull off. How would you count that? The triplet pull off? I know how you would count it, but.
Okay, so that one, again, that one is definitely pretty easy to do off of feel as well. For me, I shouldn't say that because some people don't don't feel rhythm quite the same way. Everyone has their own approach to it. But I just think of it as that as one block to me, right? I don't think of it as triple quarter note.
Yeah.
It's like just that quarter note happens to be where you're landing at the end of the triplet. Like to me, it could be, it could just be another triplet. You don't play the rest of the triplet.
Yeah.
You just hold through it. So that's how my brain processes it. I'm sure there's people out there who'd be like, that sounds stupid, but it works for me, you know?
Yeah.
But yes, you can count it as one E and two, three and, or triple it, two, three and.
Yeah. And then, I mean, it's kind of a basic solo.
Very, very basic. Like I said, there's that one A minor pentatonic lick. That's it.
Yeah.
I mean, you get that down, that's half of the solo, and the other half is this note, you know? Like, there's. It sounds cool because you got the skank strumming, you got the skank strumming, and you got the wah pedal going.
Yep.
That adds a lot of flavor to it. And the wah pedal is done quite tastefully. Like I said, hitting the wah really on that note, like.
Yeah.
You know, he's pressing it down right on that note where it kind of cuts the attack of the note off a little bit, but it sounds, it sounds really cool. Mm-hmm. It's done. Yeah, definitely done well. And to play wah, skank strumming, rhythm, triplets, wah, swing, like all that, put all those elements together and do it as well, as you hear on the record, that's a whole nother story.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I was going to say I think a lot of people early on with the wah are like every downbeat, they need to put a wah in, right? Very often.
Yeah, I think that's the standard like initial approach is to do like a wah 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 wah, like maybe with a, or maybe just like a quarter note rhythm, like you're sounding wah 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 wah.
Yeah.
But really, you want to, once you get past, well, that's a great place to start because you want to be able to do it in time and rhythm and have that and. There's plenty of wah used that way out there, plenty of examples of it. But then you kind of want to get to the point where you're choosing what part of the phrase you're putting the wah where on, like how you want it. Because sometimes it could be like you could have like a gradual wah, like a wah, 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 something like that could be cool too. And I'm just kind of playing around with it.
It adds a lot of flavor. I mean, take the wah away, it'd be a pretty boring solo. It would just not be as atmospheric, right? Which I think you can get by with
It wouldn't sound quite as funky either.
Because
that skank strumming is quite a funky technique. It's a funk guitar technique, I think originally it's funk guitar, because you also see, like I said, that I mentioned that Stevie Ray Vaughan song. Yeah. And that's blues, neo-blues, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, cool.
All right. Should we try to lay down tracks to this part?
Yeah, why not? It could be fun. Yeah. I don't have my wah pedal out, but...
I don't either. Mine's in my car, like it should be.
Mine is in a box in the next room.
As it should be.
I dismantled my pedal board.
Still? Okay. So do you want to add it right to the backing tracks?
Yeah, I don't see why not.
So I think to put me on the spot, we're going to take turns, right?
Okay.
But.
That one's going to be hard, that measure 80. I think that'd be something that you do by accident.
Yeah, you get a little bit of that note in there.
Do it.
You know what?
Intentionally.
Wait, our good intentions of recording this with the track is awesome, but I think we need to spend at least 10 minutes doing what you just said of playing it with a metronome.
Okay.
So, with the movie magic that we have, we can both do that on our own, and we can just do a fucking time lapse and not have to bore everyone with 10 minutes of a. So we'll just keep the record going. We'll both grab metronomes by ourselves and get going. That sound like a good idea? Sure.
Sounds like a good idea.
What a good idea. Well, we're smart people, Nick.
What a good idea.
This is fun.
That's our 10 minutes.
Oh, that's you know what I was thinking is if one of us was a really good guitarist and the other one was pretty shit, it'd be fun to do like a weekly who played it better.
Oh yeah, who do you think could do it on average? So I've had another thought about this one, and I really don't know, but okay. It's also doable to play the part right here the whole time. You know.
We're going back to the tape.
The only thing I don't like is that I feel like the note is a bit thicker than it would be on the high E.
Yeah.
Which this one, because I hear some juice in it.
Yeah.
And there's not a lot of juice in the high E string.
So we're going to keep it the B for now, but you can play wherever the fuck you want, right?
Yeah, you know, if it's more comfortable here.
Yeah, know, or say one of us can't play it at all. Play it wherever you want. Or don't play it. Just don't even play it. Don't even worry about it. It's not like you're doing live videos that everyone sees and you suck. You're not doing that.
Just do this.
Yeah. All right. Let me get this track up and running.
Run it. Run that track. I'm just listening to how he's using the wah. I like it. It's good. I'd have to listen to it a few times a bit closer, but the general gist I get is he's not just doing it, you know, like on a quarter note or something. It's like a phrasal thing for him.
Mm.
So on the, he does one wah up at the beginning of that, so it's wah wah wah. You know, and I think it's actually wah wah wah.
Yeah.
And then something wah 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 wah.
I think next week we both have to break out our wah pedals and actually play it, because it is pretty fucking sweet with that wah, and something that I think everyone should work on so they just don't abuse the wah.
Yes, but worthwhile definitely playing. Definitely worthwhile playing a wah solo without a wah first.
Anyway. Yeah.
So this is a good approach. Yeah. Just to get it down and then add the wah in.
So who goes first usually? I mean, I don't remember. We guess we flip a coin. Heads or tails?
Sure. Tails.
Which would be the non-side of that one. So I'm going to flip in the air and it's going to land on my computer. Right. No, you win, I go first. If you win, it's punishment to go first and look embarrassed while you're...
It's also punishment to go second and look embarrassed.
That's fair. All right, so here's my loop. I'm going to do two records and then you can do two records. Deal?
Deal.
It's going to be good. It's going to be really, really
great.
If you see a big cut here or here. All right. All is above as it below. That's a prayer. It's a prayer, right? Dude, this is going to be shit. I got it up to 110 on the metronome. I was pretty happy. How fast did you get it to?
I just followed your metronome. So okay.
You know, this is really good. If I have a longer beard when my video shot, these are all jokes. That's my take one, by the way.
Okay. So I think we learned an important lesson here.
Yep. What is it? Wait, what's yours?
My important lesson that I take from this is definitely figure out the speed of your notes before you play. Figure out what the tempo means for your triplets, for your fastest notes.
Now, if we weren't doing a contest, right, we're two in, two out, I would have gotten my metronome speed up to 140, okay? So I would actually know, right, versus my 110 that you saw in the time lapse. The other thing is I would have practiced with the track going, right, and understood it without having to put any notes in. That's two learnings that I had. The rest of your learnings are practice and get your shit together as a person and probably like buy a vestibule. That's probably your third one.
Well, really the biggest one was you just, from this side looking at it, the biggest thing was you just didn't have an idea of how fast your triplets were supposed to be. You know?
Yeah.
I speak now. I shall forever hold my peace soon.
I don't think you're going to have to. I think you can learn from all of my many mistakes and just... Your second take was pretty good. Can we listen back to your second as you save it and it loads?
Yeah, sure. Here we go. Definitely kind of rushing it yet, but man, I actually had nerves on that.
Did you? Good. Wow. Good. Isn't that good to feel alive a little bit?
A little bit. Pretty nice. Yeah. I was like, hey, you know, my heart actually beats.
Yeah, you know. It is good. And then remember that I nailed it as well. Do you remember that?
I do.
Yeah.
Actually, you killed it. I said you killed it.
With the power of editing. No, we're not done. I'm doing two more takes and you're doing two more takes.
Oh, all right.
Here we go. Yep. Yep. You ready? You ready? Shit, I'm not. So it's half nerves and half just like, and then my fingers are just fumbling on the part that I can actually could play before.
And I felt the same. I was doing better on this part. And then when, like this really easy riff, I'm just like fumbling all over it. Like, okay, cool.
It's getting to that riff though, right?
It is kind of the getting to it.
Yeah.
Takes a higher level guitarist.
Well, also, we looked at this part for all of 40 minutes, which I think is pretty good. Well, for good for you, the outcome for me is like, that's pretty much where my plane's at, so I understand that.
Sure.
Okay,
can we go? Oh, actually, no. I take that back. I really should have the solo up.
Fair. Which is interesting. I was doing a live the other day, and sometimes I read better. I play better if I read, but sometimes it's worse. That doesn't make any sense. No, overall, it is worse when I'm trying to sight read and play it because I'm reading and thinking, right?
Yeah. Well, actually, you're not wrong. Like this part, the solo is simple enough that I don't need to read it.
But you also...
Yeah. Okay, let me try without reading it. See what happens.
Well, then I won't. Never mind. That's why I couldn't do it.
Yeah, yeah. No, I hear you. I hear you. All right, here we go. Oh, I still suck balls.
Yeah.
Still not great. Still
but, I mean, in 40 minutes, I think that's pretty damn good. And if we were recording, we could just compotake if we really needed to.
Well, I mean, if I did a few of those in a row, it'd be a good one in there. It's really just getting that first note there.
Yeah.
That's all it is.
Yep.
It boils down to.
Cool. Any other thoughts on the solo?
No, not really. Adding in the wah won't be much of a big deal. You just kind of figure out where it moves, and then you go on autopilot. Or I know a good way to and we can talk about this more when we actually do the wah next time. But actually, like using your mouth or your voice, like going wah wah wah, can help you do with your foot.
Yeah, yeah. Teach your foot where you want it to go.
Right. So a lot of people, they actually use their, well, in many ways, you know, a lot of guitarists will like sing their solos along with playing them and whatnot. And that really, I don't know, I guess that it really just helps internalize it, you know?
Well, I think it goes back to you when you sing your triplets versus counting your triplets, it becomes more ingrained in your brain. Same thing with a melody.
And it's also just more part of your body then.
Yeah. Yeah. Cool. All right. Good chat.
Yep.